We are in our science, especially in our chemistry, we have already begun our chapter number 1, that is matter in our surroundings. As we have discussed in our previous video, in that what is matter? So my dear students, we understood that matter is a combination of mass and space. So anything that occupies space and mass, they are considered as a matter. We have taken example of this chalk stick. We consider this is a matter. So in that it has mass also. When it lie on the ground, it consider it take place also. So that is why anything has mass and occupy space, they are considered as a matter. That already we have discussed in our previous video. In our previous video, we also discussed the classification of matter. So in that, the classification of matter, we discuss about the physical and the chemical properties of matter. Physical and chemical properties of matter, in that we discuss the five stages of physical matter, physical properties, in that solid, liquid, gas, and two more we have discussed. One is plasma, second is BEC, that is the Bose-Einstein constant. Okay, so physical properties, in that we discuss solid, liquid, then gas, fourth number is plasma, and fifth is BEC, that is the Bose-Einstein constant. So here in the physical state of matter, we are gone through the five stages that we already have completed. Then we discuss about the chemical properties of matter. So chemical properties of matter, especially there are three main properties. That is element, compound and mixture. Element, compound and mixture. Element is a pure substance, as we are aware. Then mixture is a combination of different elements, atoms, even different compounds. So that we consider as a mixture. So here the chemical properties of matter, in that element, compound and mixture. Okay, so element is a pure substance. Second is compound. Third is mixture. Okay, so element is a pure substance. Compound are mixture of different elements, and mixtures are the two types, as we are aware, that is homogeneous and heterogeneous. Okay, so in that, these all the matters are based on their chemical properties. Now today in our discussion, the main topic we are going to discuss, that is the physical nature of matter. Now physical nature of matter will be discussed. So here we must understand here the five states of matter. So in that, solid, liquid, gas, plasma and BEC. Even we include in this, that is an element, compound and mixture. If we understood this, the physical state of matter is easy for us. So today we are going to discuss the very much important topic, that is the physical nature of matter. The physical nature of matter, in that physically we understand, we are not going through inside. Just we are looking after, and we can say that this is the physical nature of matter. Just look on. So look after. That is the physical nature. We are not talking inside, that is the chemical. So that is very much important. The physical nature of matter. So here dissolution. The five four steps are there: dissolution, diffusion, evaporation, and sublimation. So these are the four main steps of physical nature of matter. So when we discuss the physical nature of matter, the first and foremost will come, that is the dissolution. Now my friend, my dear student, what is dissolution? Now dissolution is a process, especially all our processes. This, that is the physical nature of matter, all four are processes. Dissolution, when we can say that, when salt is added into water, when salt is added into water, it will start dissolving. The dissolution process start, and that we consider as a that we call as a mixture, and that mixture is which type of mixture? It is a uniform. It is a uniform mixture. So here the uniformly the particles are embedded in it. So that we consider as a dissolution. Dissolving solution. It is a uniform solution, we can say. Uniform solution. So dissolution is a type of uniform solution. Means particles are dissolved in uniform motion. Means suppose salt is dissolved in water. So when salt is dissolved in water, after that we are unable to see that. So that is a uniform. So uniform solution we can say, that is simply the process we consider as a dissolution. Next is a diffusion. Now diffusion is what? My dear student, diffusion, we are aware that when any substance, when it has higher concentration, I am writing the concentration. When any substance move from higher concentration towards its lower concentration to make it uniform, so that we consider as a diffusion. So there are special membrane over there. So diffusion, there are special membranes. So that allow them to go from higher concentration to lower concentration. So that we consider as a diffusion. Suppose we will take example of KMnO4. Now what is KMnO4? If you see in your textbook, one activity is also given. KMnO4 is a potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate. When we add the crystals of potassium permanganate into water, the water convert into pink color. Which color? It convert into pink color. Now in this activity is mentioned that we have to take 4 to 5 beakers. In 1 beaker we are adding KMnO4, potassium permanganate. Then that same solution we are transferring into the different. Suppose A solution transfer, we are talking about this diffusion process. When A, it is added with the KMnO4, it transfer to B beaker. Then it transfer to C, it transfer to D. When successively it will transfer from A beaker to D beaker, the concentration of the substance concentration or the crystal concentration will decrease. So pink color at the first beaker, when you go to the last beaker, it will decrease. So that is about the diffusion. Diffusion is a process or intermix of molecules. Next we will have a discussion, that is evaporation. Now evaporation is what we are already aware when we talk about the water cycle. Water cycle is totally based on the evaporation process. So evaporation process, in that water generally it breaks down. So it is a liquid, but water is liquid. We all are aware water is liquid. When it transfers, so it changes into the gas. The two molecules of gases, that is hydrogen and oxygen. So that liquid convert into gas. Liquid convert into gas, that is evaporation. Understood? Evaporation we are aware. So it is a process of changing liquid. that is evaporation. So condensation process and evaporation process both are interlinked. Next we will discuss, that is the last process of physical nature of matter, that is sublimation. Now sublimation is what? Sublimation, my dear student, it is a transfer, it is a solid directly convert into gas. And gas is directly convert into solid. Remember that. Okay. Sublimation, it is a process of changing of solid into gas and gas into solid. That is sublimation. Suppose we take example, camphor. Camphor, if you know that, camphor can be generally called as a camphor. Camphor. So that camphor which is solid and then it will transfer directly into gas, that is camphor. Then naphthalene bombs. So this is also an example of sublimation process. So today we have discussed the main steps of physical nature of matter. The four processes are there: dissolution, diffusion, evaporation, sublimation. And previously we discussed what is matter, the classification of matter in that five states of matter and three chemical states of matter: element, compound and mixture. And today we discuss physical nature of matter, this all, and go through the textbook and try to understand the concept of physical nature of matter. So remaining topic we will discuss, that is characteristics of matter, in our coming video. Thank you and have a nice day.